Bishop Fox will have Brother John Locke as a speaker. After Brother Locke, we'll have a solo, a special number by Sheila Wallace. There is a green hill far away. And following Sister Wallace, we'll hear from Brother Huebner. After Brother Huebner's talk, we'll have a moment where we will basically open the opportunity for all those who would like to share thoughts and memories of Brother Wessel. And we'll take to that point. Bishop Fox.
Donald Hubert Wessel was born July 30th, 1937, at D Hospital in Ogden, Utah, to Hubert LeRae Wessel and Ethelene Mabel Clayton's. The family moved to Baltimore in 1943. Don started attending school at Patapsco Neck Elementary School. Don's father enjoyed traveling and, whenever possible, took the family on trips to all the surrounding areas of Baltimore and several states. In 1945, Don began a long career of 50 years in the Boy Scouts of America. He served as patrol leader, junior leader, scout master, cub master, and district chairman. Scouting was a very rewarding experience for him. He graduated from Towson High School in 1954. While attending the University of Maryland, he played in the marching band and was a member of the Alpha Phi Omega fraternity. In 1959, he married Jean Palmer and celebrated the birth of their daughter, Alice Jean Wessel. As a member of the Baltimore Grotto, he enjoyed cave exploring and had many exciting experiences deep down in caves. In 1965, he married Catherine McCurley. They met at a young adult fireside. For Don, it was love at first sight. He often said the spirit told him she was the one. So on their first date, he asked her to marry him. 6 months later, they were married and enjoyed a wonderful life together for 52 years. His teaching career began at North Bethesda Junior High School and continued for 37 years. He taught at Middle River Junior High School, City College, Eastern High School, Talmudical Academy, Southwestern High School, and was promoted to Science Department Head at Marienthaler Biotech. As a second job, he taught behind the wheel driver's education. He continued teaching that for 30 years. After a hectic session of driving, he would sit at the dining room table and work on a latch hook rug. Thus, he was called the Happy Hooker. He continued improving his education by attending many summer courses and workshops. In 1968, he received his master's degree from Morgan State College. He was qualified to teach all the sciences, but especially liked teaching physics. In 1966, Don and Kathy purchased a house at 3830 Taylor Avenue. It was strange to them that their address, 3830, corresponded to the scriptures from Doctrine and Covenants 3830, which says, "If ye are prepared, ye shall not fear." Being prepared was very important to Don. Together, Don and Kathy worked to have at least a year's supply of food and to be financially secure. In 1967, they drove to the Oakland Temple to be sealed for time and eternity. The arrival of his son, Alexander, in 1968 gave him great joy. He looked forward to teaching his son about scouting. In 1971, his sweet daughter, Carmen, arrived, adding to his joy of fatherhood. In his spare time, he made projects for his children to enjoy. One such project was building a dollhouse for Carmen that took almost his entire summer vacation. Camping was a fun family activity. A pop-up trailer was purchased and driven across country many times. Upon retiring, he satisfied a lifelong dream to travel. Many exciting trips were taken to Europe, Panama Canal, Hawaii, Alaska, and numerous other places. His church activity kept him busy as well. He served in many church positions. One of his favorite was an 8-year mission as manager of the Bishop's Storehouse. He faithfully served in that calling until his health started to fail. A hip replacement was required and limited his activity. The Lord provided another calling out of strenuous, that of manager of the Family History Library. He was a very organized person and spent many hours organizing the materials and perfecting daily operations. As the years progressed, his health became a major issue. He found indexing to fill his time. Many hours were spent at the computer indexing. It presented a new challenge and one he found great enjoyment in doing. Beside him at the computer was always a jar of M&Ms, which he loved very much. Just a few a day, he would say, Of course, he had to rinse them down with a big gulp of half diet and half regular Pepsi. Don will be remembered for his sense of humor, cracking a quick response, and his contagious smile. Service to his fellow men was very important to him. Whenever possible, he could reach out to help others, either giving them information for their improvement or just listening. He often quoted him 2:19, "Because I have been given much, I too must give." On February 24th, 2018, the Lord welcomed him home for his final vacation. I say that in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.